Jesus was baptized here, now it's holy water, so I took some holy water because in my religion they use it many times throughout the year, so it's good to actually have real holy water from the source.
I'm sure God above is also sad that so much global warming, et cetera, so many things have happened, you know, to what he thought was probably going to, you know, nourish us forever. So that makes me, that part makes me feel really sad, to be honest.
In Christianity, we all know Jesus was baptized in the Jordan. I know because churches were built all facing east.
We can just simply imagine John's baptizing the believers here, eating wild honey and locust, waiting for the arrival of Jesus Christ. And the wilderness that we see surrounding the cave where John lived is the wilderness John the Baptist described himself living in.
I think the most important challenge is from technical point of view is the availability of the water resources here in the region. And as you know, the water resources availability is already affected diversely with the impact of the climate change. When the water is available in the region, I think the solution of the Jordan River will be more and more easier. And all the government, and not all the local government in the region, are responsible for this international heritage. I think the international community also is responsible to find solution, either from technical point of view or from financial point of view, in order to construct the project which could contribute in the medium run and the long run.
María, yo te bautizo en el nombre del Padre.
Llena una botellita con una nieta mía de camino.
This is the first most important plan to revive a river in the last 20 years. The last time we had such a big project was in the restoration of the Elkhorn River in Tel Aviv, in the central of Israel. And the importance of the Jordan River, of course, is it's in its cultural, biblical, religious importance, and therefore it's so important to revive and to invest into this specific river. The plan is to finish it by 2025, and by then each year from almost 30 million cubic meters of water that flow there today, we are going to have an addition of another 40 million cubic meters annually. Jordan rightfully expects Israel to pay for the majority of this project. First of all, we're the biggest users of the water that are going to be used through the river. Second of all, we're the biggest polluters of the river as as it is in the situation that it is today. Thirdly, we are much richer than Jordan, and we have to be more generous with our neighbors. We have a huge security geopolitical interest in maintaining our border with Jordan, which is the biggest Israeli border, with peaceful neighbors. And this is a small price to pay if you compare it to a war that might break over water. And in such a region like ours, which is so thirsty for water, we cannot allow ourselves any war because of these issues.